What's up guys, it's Tom here and welcome to a very exciting Liverpool transfer news video. And German, English and Italian newspapers, news outlets are reporting that Liverpool are interested in signing Borussia Mönchengladbach defender, German international Matthias Ginter, who is 25 years old and he's a much more reliable player in terms of injuries than either Joel Matip or Lovren. The newspapers are saying that Liverpool will probably offload Joel Matip because that's their fourth choice centre-back. But let me know, what do you think? Would he be a good replacement for either Matip and Lovren? As I said, he's 25 years old and he used to work for Jurgen Klopp at Borussia Dortmund. In Jurgen Klopp's last season as Borussia Dortmund manager, he signed Ginter as a 20-year-old, very talented centre-back, and he played with Jurgen Klopp for 1 year at Dortmund, and he is a very, very good player, very reliable as well. Borussia Mönchengladbach are doing very well in the Bundesliga on a limited budget. They are well on course to finish in the Champions League places. They are at the moment third place. And also, he played 40 games for Dortmund 3 seasons ago, 41 games 2 seasons ago, and last season, in his first season in Borussia Mönchengladbach colors, he played 37 games. And also, he scored 5 goals last season for Mönchengladbach. This season, he already has 20 games. And apart from an injury layoff in December, he was an ever-present for the Borussia Mönchengladbach team. And defensive injuries have really hindered Liverpool this season. We had Joe Gomez out for a few months now. Dejan Lovren, the same. He just can't recover, can't seem to recover from a hamstring injury. Thank goodness Matip could stay fit for a longer period of time, because otherwise we would have been able to only play with Fabinho as a centre-back instead of Fabinho in midfield. And since Ginter went to Borussia Mönchengladbach, he really improved as a player. He is now one of their best defenders, and I think he would be a terrific signing for Jurgen Klopp, not only because they have a personal relationship, they know each other from their Dortmund days, but also because Ginter is a very, very good centre-back who can even be better and improve. As you know, centre-backs mature and get better with age, so Ginter's probably his best years are still ahead of him. 25 years old is a very good age for a centre-back. And also Arsenal and Tottenham are among clubs who are looking at Matthias Ginter, so that shows me that he's a very good player. And as I said, he's a German international. He already played 23 times for the German national team. He was the youngest player in Germany's 23-man squad for the 2014 FIFA World Cup, and he went on to win the tournament, so he's a world champion, even though he didn't really play, but he was he was 20 years old at that. And also he was part of the squad for the 2016 Summer Olympics, where Germany won the silver medal. And also in 2017 he won the FIFA Confederations Cup, that's the pre-tournament for the World Cup. And also he was selected for the 23-man squad for the 2018 FIFA World Cup. He is the only outfield player in German football history who participated in 2 World Cup campaigns without playing a single minute. Wow, that's a kind of a pop quiz answer. Oh my goodness, but that doesn't really mean anything, because he's still a very, very good player. He played 23 times for the German national team already. He played 6 times in 2018. So yes, he's not the first choice centre back for Germany, but still he's a very, very good player. So I'm really hoping that Liverpool will sign him, because apart from Virgil van Dijk, we don't have another centre back who we can rely on week in, week out, and who can stay fit for the majority of the season. I mean, take a look at the numbers that Joe Gomez, Matip and Lovren have each season. They don't come even close to 40 games, which is a worry, because if Liverpool wants to win multiple Premier League titles and the Champions Leagues in the next 5 years, and I think that's what Liverpool should aim at, that's what Liverpool are aiming at, we need to have 2 centre-backs who we can rely on week in, week out. And if it wasn't for Matthias Ginter, My other choice would be probably Matthijs de Ligt of the Ajax centre-back, who is also Dutch international. But anyway, whatever Jurgen Klopp decides, I think he will bring in a new centre-back in the summer transfer window because we desperately need it. Lovren, it looks like his days are numbered at Liverpool. Matip, one of them will go, in my opinion. I'm not sure which one should go. At the moment, it looks like Lovren is the most likely to be sold because of his recurring injury problems. I'm not sure what is going on with Lovren's hamstring, but he keeps re-injuring it and his recovery keeps getting more and more complicated. So let me know what they think about that. Who should replace either Matip or Lovren? Who would be your first choice? My first choice would be De Ligt, closely followed by Matthias Ginter, who is a very, very good player in my opinion. And if you watch the Borussia Dortmund game, Borussia Mönchengladbach games, sorry, he has been a very good centre-back. And no team can be third in the Bundesliga without having a good defence, in my opinion. So he's a very good defender. Let's hope Liverpool sign him. And Sadio Mane, after playing as a striker, as a number 9, for the first time against Watford, he gave a very funny interview. He said, "To be honest, I was quite surprised. I never played there before. I was nervous. Before the game, the coach called me and said, 'Okay, we are going to make some changes. Sadio, you have to play number 9. I said, "Oh," and I looked at my teammates. I was laughing and I said, "We are a team, so you have to trust me." They were all laughing at me, but I said, "From today, call me Ronaldo or Firmino." And I find that absolutely hilarious. The banter, the camaraderie among the Liverpool players in the dressing room must be brilliant. And Gini Wijnaldum said to Mane, "You have to score. If you score, we will call you Ronaldo. If not, you are shit." Basically, that's what he said. "I was lucky to score 2 goals, but honestly, I don't mind. I'm happy to play left or right side, but if the team or Klopp needs me as a striker, I will try again." And Mane also added, "Of course, it is one of the more important derbies because we know what we want this season, but after all, it is like any other game. We need to focus and give everything to win it." And many, many players and many pundits are saying that this is a must-win game for Liverpool in the title race, and I agree. Former Liverpool defender Phil Babb, he also said this is a must-win game. He said, "If they win every game, they win the Premier League. Klopp will try his hardest to play down and diffuse the idea that it might get into their heads with his charisma, but every single player knows all the talk is about the title. Everyone is talking about the confidence issues and how they are feeling. They have only lost one game this season, which puts them in good stead for the last 10. If you look at it as a block, this is the title run in now. This is where you earn your money. This is where you can become immortal in Liverpool history by winning the title after such a long period of time, and they will know that. Sometimes you find the different elements of people's characters in these situations. They've got the quality. It would be psychologically massive if they lose this weekend. Ultimately, it's a must-win game." And I agree with him. And Jurgen Klopp said some very interesting things about the title race, also about the derbies, about the rivalry, and what it means for him and what it means for the Liverpool fans. So listen to this. "Look, I was 7 years at Mainz and 7 years at Dortmund," Klopp said. "When I came to Dortmund, the first 3 games were Cottbus, Leverkusen and Schalke. Nobody spoke about the other 2 teams. You know that the Schalke-Dortmund derby is like the Ruhr area derby. And that's the biggest game in their season. You have to learn, it's not my enemy. How could it be? Schalke was not my enemy when I left Dortmund. But I understood 100% what it means to the people because I had my derby when I was 10 years old and we played against the village next to us." Oh, that's brilliant. "We went to the same school and we went on the same bus. You want to win that game so desperately. That's sports. I understand that, but I don't live that. In the games, I know that we are like the tip at the end of the arrow for the people. We have to do it. They cannot win these games in the office. We have to do it on the pitch. We all understand it 100%. Wow, that is going to be a very, very interesting talk before the Merseyside derby. Of course, goals can change a season. Origi's winner changed the mood, of course, the confidence. It was a very important one. 100%. That day and the games afterwards, it was unbelievable what the boys did. Just to add my commentary, in December, thanks in part to that Origi winner against Everton, we won all our games, which really put us into a very good position in the title race. It created all our situations, really. We were constantly in the top part of the table, and then December changed a lot. That was very important. Jurgen Klopp is saying that he doesn't live like he hates Everton, but he understands the fans' feelings and he wants to win the derby for the fans. And also because it would be a massive 3 points in the title race, because Everton would love nothing more than to derail Liverpool's title challenge. So Liverpool, we have to be at 100% at Goodison Park if we want to win that. But the good news is we will know already what Man City's result is for the weekend. So that could be a benefit. If Manchester City win, all the pressure will be on Liverpool. But if Man City lose or draw against Bournemouth, which can happen, I'm not sure it will happen. I expect Man City to win, but it can happen. They can lose points because last season they required a last minute Raheem Sterling winner to win away at Bournemouth. So anything can happen in the title race. Then if Man City lose points against Bournemouth, it will be massive for Liverpool. So we shall wait and see. Van Dijk said, "I've played in the Old Firm derby, which is really intense. When I played Rangers with Celtic, Rangers were a lower level side than they are now, so it was pretty easy back then. But this is the Premier League, it is totally different. It will be a game that can go either way, and sometimes in these types of games, it is who wants it the most. We are in a position where we definitely want it the most, and hopefully we can show it on the pitch. That is going to be a very, very fiery and very hectic, very brutal Merseyside derby. The most anticipated Merseyside derby in quite a long time." And even Peter Crouch said in his newspaper column, "They need to take care of the Merseyside derby, Liverpool. Win this battle and they really can start to believe in winning the title." Paul Ince, former Liverpool and Man United player, said in an interview, "Against Watford, that was the title-winning Liverpool we saw 4 or 5 weeks ago. And for most of the season, I would say Manchester City were nervous looking at that." And I agree with him. Man City were really hoping that Liverpool would crack under pressure and that Liverpool would lose the momentum even more, because, to be frank, Liverpool drew 3 of the last 4 games. So there were definitely a slump. And against Leicester and West Ham, we didn't really play well. Against Man United, we didn't play well at all. But against Bournemouth and now against Watford, we were at our best. The big question is, which Liverpool side will turn up at Everton? And we have to be at 100%. The good news is that it looks like Mane and Salah are back in full form. Firmino, it looks like, will be back from his injury. Trent Alexander-Arnold is back in full form. He got 3 assists against Watford and he took home the match ball. Even Jurgen Klopp said that normally you get the match ball after scoring 3 goals, but getting 3 assists, and he is the youngest player to ever do that in a Premier League game, he deserves a match ball, I believe. So that's brilliant. And Paul Merson said some very interesting compliments about Liverpool. He said, "If I was at a club now, I would want to be at Liverpool as a player. You could make history and do something that will be remembered until the day they will die. These players are there to make history. If someone would have said to me 29 years ago that Liverpool were not going to win the league in that long, I would have said, you are joking me." And I fully agree. I mean, Liverpool had a 20-year period in the 70s and 80s where they pretty much won the title every other season on average, maybe even more than that. And then Man United had a 20-year period from like 95 to 2015, about that time, where Man United were winning the title every other season on average. So now it's going to be interesting which era is next. Since then, Chelsea and Man City won the league, and also Leicester with a freak league title. But if Liverpool could get back to winning titles, it would be massive, because the next 5 years this Liverpool team will only get better, and that is very, very promising, and I'm really, really looking forward to the next 5 years and covering Liverpool for you guys on YouTube, because it's so much fun and I'm really, really enjoying reading your comments as well. And also Paul Merson said, if you were going to say to me every season that you would start at the beginning of March 1 point clear at the top of the table, you would take that. So Liverpool need to look at this situation with that perspective. We should forget that we dropped points in the past 3 or 4 rounds of the Premier League. We should just be grateful that we are in this position and go all in with everything that we have to win that first Premier League title. Paul Merson also said, they need to have a meeting and the manager is very important in this. He needs to calm the players down because they are top of the league. They are not chasing anyone, it's in their hands. And that's a very good point by Paul Merson, who is a quite controversial pundit, but sometimes I really enjoy his opinion because he has been part of Arsenal for so many years. And Brendan Rodgers, in an interview where he was announced as a Leicester City manager, and he gave an extensive interview to Leicester, he said some very interesting things about his time at Liverpool, and I want to tell you that, because these are some inside information that we haven't known about previously. When I went into Liverpool, my job in the first season was to cut the budget. You only need to look at the players who left: Maxi Rodriguez, Aquilani, Pepe Reina. The job was to cut the budget, bring in a younger team. In January, we were able to make the first couple of signings. Before 20 million, we bought in Daniel Sturridge and Philippe Coutinho. And obviously, as time wore on, our style and identity grew with the training and the work we put in. In the second season, we nearly won the title and qualified for the Champions League. The objective was to get into the top four. The third year was difficult because we lost Luis Suarez and the whole thing exploded because we arrived in the Champions League. It was a shame for me because it would have been great to have had the team I had in the second year. Our feeling at the end of the second season was that we had a really strong team with a strong identity. Of course, Luis Suarez left and we didn't quite get the right replacement. So the third season became a lot tougher for us, and Steven Gerrard was leaving at the end of that season as well. We only got 8 games into the fourth season and the club decided to make a change. Jurgen has come in and has done an excellent job. I went to Celtic and they had the most amazing experience. So yeah, I don't really blame you, Brendan Rodgers, for what happened at Liverpool, because he overachieved overall. If you look at the Liverpool squad at that time, to get so close to the Premier League title within like touching distance with a squad that was not even favorites to finish in the top four, it's a remarkable achievement. And replacing Luis Suarez is always going to be impossible, and I think his recruitment let him down, because bringing in Ricky Lambert and Mario Balotelli, who wasn't at all suited to the way Liverpool played, because with Suarez we had a very creative player who is fast, who is skillful, and with Balotelli and Ricky Lambert they are tall, muscular guys who are more of a target man. We should have brought in somebody who is very similar in playing style to Luis Suarez, and then it would have been much better in my opinion for the third season. But the rest is history. In the end, for Liverpool it turned out better, because we brought in Jurgen Klopp, and that was the best signing that Liverpool made in the past 30 years, I'm pretty sure, because he's one of the top 5 best managers in world football. Let's win that first Premier League title. Come on, Liverpool. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice Saturday. See you later, guys. Goodbye.